AskReddit by Jonathan Quiridman. Redditors, what is the most fucked up thing you have ever done? Was night manager at fast food establishment during college. There was a bitter prank rivalry between our establishment and the Subway next to us. After months of prank escalation, I crammed a rotting hamburger patty in the handle of the Subway manager's trunk lid so he went knuckle deep in rotting burger when he went home. That was the end of the prank war and I've never forgiven myself for crossing the red line. Subway staff the next day, those burger fuckers are absolutely unhinged. Sociopaths. Let's not fuck with them anymore. I'm gonna rat my little sister out. During our parents' divorce and amp custody battle, we were forced to sit in on family counseling sessions. I was 12 and amp, she was 8. We thought my mom was acting funny and amp might have been banging the counselor on the side for her own personal testimonial interests, still not confirmed. So we were pissed off because we loved our mom and our dad. It seemed like the counselor favored our mom over our dad, and it got rough sometimes watching him become outed by the only two adult forces who didn't love him in this world. Anyway, my little sister and I were left alone in his office, and she decided she was gonna take a shit in his little trash can to assert dominance. It was asserted. We never went back. They say that in every generation there's a hero. Deleted. And I guess that's enough Reddit for me tonight. You know how people bag up their leaves and leave them out by the street? As a teen we used to go out at night and dump them back out on people's lawns. Thinking about it now I would be so pissed if someone did that to me. I've spent the entire day raking leaves. Sometimes up to 18-20 bags. This is cruel lol. Edit. For everyone wondering why leaves are raked and bagged, the leaves kill the grass because they block the light and suffocate the grass. When I was about 15, a neighbor or ours stopped us in the road and chewed us out for riding our go-karts in the road. This despite the fact that it was a dirt road in a rural area which was the perfect place for riding go-karts. He was a complete asshole about it too. I don't know where I got the idea from, but I promptly went home, called the electric company, pretended to be the neighbor, and told them I wanted my electricity turned off as we were moving. It was the 80s, so they just looked the account up by name and address and promptly entered my request in the system. I'm sure it was just a minor inconvenience for them, but they deserved it in my opinion. For some reason this seems like extremely 80s type revenge. Sometimes you can do really fucked up things without any intent or awareness. I was young and with a very nice woman who was struggling with some physical issues that resulted in a severe depression. We weren't living together, but I was regularly getting up early and going over to her place for breakfast and to kind of just check in and let her know I was there for her. I went drinking with some friends one night and I overslept the next morning. I called her to let her know I wouldn't make it. She committed suicide that day, before I got back from work. I know, now, that what happened wasn't my fault, and I wasn't responsible, at least not in some overt way. We all make our own decisions. Still, I will always wish I hadn't been careless and overslept that day. If I had the chance to change one decision I've made in my life, this would be it. She had already decided. You gave her lots of company and did help her. It wasn't for nothing. You're all disgusting. Anyways, I made the Pringles can flashlight once. It's a cylinder. These answers are veering wildly between funny and depressing as fuck. Sprinkle a little criminal activity and baby, you got a stew point. Not the most fucked up. The roommates of my girlfriend were making her life very difficult, leaving garbage rotting in her room while on vacation, piercing our condoms and more. I used to pee on their bath sponges. Never told them. How spiteful do you have to be to pierce other people's condoms? My 12-year-old dumbass thought, after watching videos on YouTube, that applying honey to your eyes directly can change light and its color naturally. Boy, it was painful. A weak mayo. I pooped in the bed of a schoolmate's truck during school hours. Where's the truck supposed to sleep now? My mom's boyfriend is a dick, so I used his beard trimmer to shave my nuts. A few times. He probably used it for that as well, so you guys might have indirectly touched balls. I had something similar where I was walking home from summer band practice and had explosive diarrhea really badly. Middle of the summer in Texas. Most bushes were either cacti or dead and I was walking through a neighborhood. Long story short, there was this tiny house, one of them plastic houses that little kids play in. I went in there, closed the door, squatted down and took a shit in the corner. I sometimes wonder if the family tried to guess if a wild animal went in their little girl's playhouse and took a dump. I assure you they knew it was human. Computer air duster. Don't use inhalants, kids. They're real bad. I think my IQ dropped by about 30 points from that stuff. Edit. Another reason not to do it. Posting in this thread has made me think about it a bunch and has reawakened cravings for it. How am I still craving something I haven't touched in 7 years and I know is the worst thing I've ever done to my body? I wish more people would take this seriously. Huffing claimed my brother's life. Nobody knew he was doing it. Been almost 3 years. RIP Phil. I wish I could have been there more for you. I woke up from a blackout drunk in a bathroom of a house I've never been in before. It was a model home a few miles from my apartment at the time. I staggered back home sometime around 4 a.m. Oh, it was also my birthday and I was alone those few days. I stole a laptop from my old job. It was a brand new MacBook that they ordered one too many of and just sat in a closet for the 3 years I worked for this huge corporation. I was it, so I knew how and had the ability to wipe it from all the records. I feel kinda bad about it cause it's worth a lot, so a felony theft, but they really didn't even know it existed and I needed a computer. I chalk it up to all the unpaid OT I worked to make me feel better. I could only hit 40 by contract and some jobs required more than that per week. Probably the least fucked up thing in this thread TBH. Not mine, but a co-worker of mine once told me when his wife gave birth to their son, after she went to sleep after all the pushing of labor and stuff, he went out and fucked some other girl. My half-brother was actively cheating on his wife while she was having an emergency C-section and almost bled out. When I was young, some people in my neighborhood always complained to me and the other children about everything. We couldn't play football in D Street or make too much noise or hide behind their car while playing hide and seek, etc. One day we had enough of it and took their garden hose and stuck it in the mailbox, that in my country is their opening in the door, and turned it on and ran away. I don't even want to know how much water damage they had because of that. The wet bandits. 8th grade. It was the last week of school and we had to turn in our end of the year history assignment. Now I was very lazy with school stuff but would also get grounded if I got bad grades. I procrastinated so bad to the point there wasn't really a way out of it. One day in class, our teacher tells us he has a stack of history projects that were turned in that didn't have a name on them. I get a light bulb. I go over to the stack and find a project on Civil War era weaponry like cannons and stuff. Funny thing was, it actually did have a name on it. It was just written in pencil on black paper and hard to see. I erased the name, put my name on it and turned it in. Never got caught. Sorry, Haley. I'm really surprised you got away with it. It seems easy for H to just go and show a file or even recite a lot of the paper, meanwhile you would show up empty-handed or not even know anything about it. I was at a club. I met a girl. I am also a girl. She was super trashed by the time the bar closed and everyone gets kicked out. I've been raped before, and took initiative to get her home safe. Luckily she was staying somewhere close, as I found out by using her phone to text someone who knew her. I got her back to her expensive hotel room, where her friend was. I declined to party with them, and went home. I was also drunk, and the next day I found her earrings, and a couple hundred dollars in my purse. I definitely stole it from her. She definitely wasn't the type to miss it, but still wrong. Smoked a cigarette full of pubic hair for money. How much money? When I was in the army I got pretty low. I put the barrel of my rifle in my mouth and pulled the trigger. Gun jammed. Sometimes I wonder if that was a miracle or a curse. Similar. I owe my life to shitty mil surplus ammo. Came home from the war. Month later it's my birthday. Put my Mosin in mouth. Towed the trigger and click biggest sigh. Lots of tears. And then rejoined my day party. It made me really contemplate quantum immortality and all of that, and if in that timeline everyone heard the blast, Mosin's allowed, and saw the aftermath. I sent my cheating first husband's mom printouts of all his Craigslist ads, emails, dating profiles, and letters I'd found. He was terrified of his mom knowing how scummy her son is. Reading through these answers, I'm a lot less fucked up than I thought. I'm downright a shiny, boring paragon of normality after looking at this thread. Taught Sunday school after a night of rolling on ecstasy. And before going into my classroom to start my lesson, I threw up in the bathroom because I popped too much Percocet. After my sister killed herself, my mom asked me if it was her fault, and I chose a kind path and told her no. From there forward, the toxic behaviors that pushed my sister to kill herself and my parents got worse until I had no choice but to cut them off. I could have chosen the hard path that led to growth and healing. I don't know if answering otherwise would have changed anything, but if your child hanging herself in your attic isn't enough for a person to change, what is? Stranger, I can absolutely guarantee that from the picture you paint, Jesus Christ, Buddha and the Queen could have came down from heaven and told your mother it was 100% her fault, and the amount of self-reflection would have been exactly the same. After my mother had a stroke that nearly rendered her paralyzed, I visited her in the hospital, and while she slept I whispered in her ear that I hope she died and freed me from the burden of having her as a mother. I'm not sure if she heard me or not, but we don't talk anymore. For reference, she was incredibly abusive and neglectful of me all through my childhood. But saying those words felt like the worst thing I could have ever said to someone. Sometimes we need to try on our biggest villain's persona just to feel what that perspective is like. It's only natural. And you prove to yourself that who she was, wasn't who you are. Take care of yourself and seek therapy if you haven't and have the means. All the love from this random Redditor. When I was married, my ex-wife and I went to a bar with a couple friend. They were more her friends than mine. The wife of the couple made it clear she didn't like me and spent the evening taking as many shots at me as possible. As she got drunker, the insults became more frequent and meaner. My attempts to fire back were stopped by her husband and my ex-wife. I was expected to take it but not give it. She went to the restroom and as she got off her chair, the leg broke and she face planted. Ex-wife and bitch went to the restroom, husband of bitch went to find the manager. I swapped chairs with the table next to ours, and told the manager that the injury, a broken nose, wasn't due to a broken chair but because she was drunk and fell over. Bah, this is the best story so far. Had sex with a pair of twins, at different times. And for a long time wasn't sure if I'd actually banged them both or the same one twice, and still don't know the difference. Should have marked the hand of the first twin with a marker. Mitchell Scott 101. I served a woman an eviction notice on Christmas Eve. She had just gotten out of the hospital and was bedridden on her couch, while her husband slept the few hours he had between his three jobs. It's the worst thing I've ever done. I quit that job shortly afterwards. She was so nice too. Fuck. I once had to serve a lawsuit on someone dying in hospice, because my firm's client was suing her over some stupid petty shit. Like, literally had to walk up to her bed as she lay there dying and let her know she was getting sued in a neighbor dispute. Then she died and I had to change the lawsuit to sue her estate instead. Fucking hell.